Hello, welcome to the new Kondratis DLC. Well, to be honest, I'm a little disappointed because they messed up the campaign again and the difficulty is not balanced and we have a lot of problems, but let's go for skirmish. As you can see, there are plenty of people playing right now, skirmishes and co-op and a lot of other stuff. So if you want to play the game, this is the time to do it. I hope the game will have a more stable player base. And we're here because I want to show you what you can do with the Psychic. The Psychic, well, let's just say that the Elysium are the DPS or the hybrid classes. The Hallbergs, the Hellfire was kind of like the tank, and this is the crowd control. By low location, by low, B location, by location. I guess it creates a decoy, and that decoy will deal damage when it explodes. It also spreads, huh? Anyway, Pulse looks like it's a. It places a buff that will give you speed, so I guess if you pick it up, you'll get a speed buff. Cooldown is 2 seconds. Activation range is 3000. Mind Blast. Mind Blast is exactly how it sounds. It pushes away the enemy, so this is crowd control 101. You'll never be swarmed by the smaller creatures. Never again. Apportation basically teleports the enemy creatures, which will be very, very useful. For example, you teleport the enemy creatures into a minefield or even an airstrike or even a nuke. Of course, I'm not sure if you can teleport the bigger creatures, but it has its uses probably. Gravity, again, this is the crowd control maximum. Look at it. The duration is 6 seconds, the cooldown is 10 at max level, so that means you'll be able to use it up pretty frequent. Of course, the stronger ones will not be so easy to lift off. But Gravity and Psy Blast, which is basically pulse damage, it deals what, 12,000 kinetic damage. Great damage, to be honest. Activation cost only 30, cooldown 6 seconds, but as you can see, you will lose. Self damage will be 80, so it's like those psychic powers from the movies. If you use your psychic powers, your nose will start to bleed, so you'll know your nose will start bleeding until you die. So I guess later in the campaign, when we have a lot more healing regeneration, we have more items, more bonuses, buffs, a proper medic, we'll be able to spam some of these abilities. Force wall, impenetrable wall, could be good, could be bad, reality mixer. Could be good, could be bad, same thing. The cooldown is a little big on this one, I'm not sure, but Maelstrom seems like it's probably going to be one of the main uses, of course. It also deals energy damage and cooldown is quite big, but the activation cost is small. Of course, damage-wise is probably one of the better buildings in the game. So I guess Gravity, Psy Blast and Maelstrom will be the main abilities. You don't really need the gun if you can use these abilities as often as you like. Okay, so if you remember, kind of the description of the Corporation Elysium has a lot of technology, has a lot of combat suits. Combat suits are basically Iron Man costumes or Iron Man suits, except a little stronger and more tactical. Well, I guess they are Man of War costumes, suits. Hallbergs, of course, they have the heavy artillery, the heavy soldiers, not a lot of combat suits, but they have a military structure, bunkers and all of that. Kondratis are basically like the super soldier, I mean, just super soldiers with a lot of numbers and decent tech, but not a lot of combat suits, and they what they lack in, of course, technology and power, they make up in numbers and cunning. Yeah, okay, like that. Now, to be honest, I really want to play the game on hard. We'll begin on hard, but some of the missions we'll have to do on easy. Because the first mission I failed it 2 times.
Marshal, you're needed back at base for a firmware update for your suit. Once I wrap up my mission, I'll join you there. Afterwards, we'll continue your psychic training.
Artillery support, air support. Anyway, the facilities we have are pretty interesting. 3D printer requires supplies, but makes supplies but requires specialists. I guess we can trade some of the specialists for supplies, which would be great since we'll eliminate the problem that we had with supplies in the Holoplex campaign. It will also be able to lower infestation. So this is not a permanent base like the Super Fortress or Dachi. From what I can see, it's kind of like a land train. So Elysium has this huge land cruiser, which is basically like a ship on land. Holberg says the Super Fortress or Dachi, and we have this train. Choo choo. I think we start in Valley Marines as. No, we start on Noakis, I think, with Holberg starts in Noakis. Elysium starts in Tarsis or Olympus, I think. Yeah, it doesn't really matter. And we start over here. In Lucas. Okay, so Desperate Charge, Bastion, Region minus one infestation adds Intel, super important as well. So yeah, this will be most the very important technology, Repair Vlak. I guess or Vlak or Shen can get damaged through various means or by traveling. Equip contact troops. This looks like a very good one, especially because we have pizza time. I mean, everything else kind of makes sense or kind of self-explanatory except pizza time. But probably misplaced technology is the one that I'll use the most, because crate will contain a certain amount of supplies as well. You are basically going to steal technology from the other corporations. Let's research that one. You can also train the specialist in the combat suits, but... yeah. It's going to be very expensive. I suggest you train up a medic or an assault. I'm not sure if we'll get one. Replicator technology like in Star Wars. This is more about the story of the planet Mars itself and some of the backline. I mean, look at backstory. We have ziplines because they're installing them and they're using them. 3D printers are the worst version of the replicator tech. The formation, the government of the Arcadian government. Kind of like a democracy, so no one has full control. There's basically 15 people and a president or whatever. I guess in the first campaign, we helped the Arcadian government escape, which are these people, which are kind of probably like the regular government or military forces that are left. Cobra is just a very fast-moving truck. Characters, Marshall, that's us. Marshall is a Class A psychic. And Zoe, so it's a good thing that they kind of bring back other characters from the first game over here, because you kind of know more about the games themselves, and yeah, anyway, it's good what they're doing. They're kind of keeping track of their lore. Reward follower. The problem is, in the beginning you don't have a lot of skills. We barely have enough. We can take the flashbang steams. I guess we can take the grenade and the critical strike, and that's about it over there. And over here we'll probably need the shock troopers, because you can summon units with it. Heal, okay. It will also be super important. I guess we're playing as the medic. Not many weapons available in the beginning. We can also use the Crusader. It's kind of interesting the way it's imagined. We have less speed, but good melee defense and damage. And also does chain lightning. Not great versus tough targets. I can imagine that. Huh. Brand, I don't like your name. You'll use the Crusader. Oh, come on. They didn't even bother to update the models for the hands. I mean, this is happening because the models for the soldiers are smaller than the combat suits, so you'll see a lot of problems with them. For example, this guy, the way he's holding his weapon, it's floating in his arms because the combat suit is bigger. I was hoping this would be a lot more technological, like the shields and the stun rods or the stun staffs from Star Wars. Okay, doesn't matter. Life support, power core. I guess that doesn't really matter. I'm very curious to see how that will handle itself. So yeah, I lost the first mission 2 times because I was playing on the hard difficulty. Don't try to finish the first mission on hard difficulty. You'll suffer a lot. Is there any merit in having someone with the Rhino pistol? Probably. Okay, this should be fine. No. Mission setup will be easy. Don't do it on the... I mean, The difference is not so big. Look at hard. Hard means health minus 10%. I don't know, it's bugged. That's what I can say, it's bugged. The numbers don't really reflect the quality, the changes they say there'll be. For example, on very hard, or I mean on hard, I think they have 2000 HP, 2200. On easy, they have 1800. So you'll see what I mean. I'm just going to record this as it is because I want the developers to remember that they dropped the ball again with this campaign as well. They don't.
Greetings,
they need
Marshall,
to...
and welcome back. We're waiting for you in the laboratory. This won't take long, as I know you're busy, especially with Zoe being your mentor.
Steady, no speed. They need to handcraft the map. They need to handcraft certain things, like the position of the defending forces. You know, the items on the ground. I never got a plasma explosive the first time I played. Yeah, okay, let's also summon the soldiers. From what I can see, they remain all the time on the ground. So if I press the skill again, and if I already have 2 soldiers, I'll have 4 soldiers. So that's great. That means at some point you can have your little army that can get smashed by the bigger enemies, but eh, who cares? Probably be very fun to run around with a bigger group. Even though you know they'll not do much. And I was also under the impression that the guards are only available for the combat suits, because a normal human would not be able to fire them or hold them or stuff like that, but I don't know. It did a lot of weird things with this DLC. I think the DLC will be okay in the end, but they could have, you know, tried a little harder, especially with this map. You have to turn on the power Y. This is just a waste of time over here right now. This is our way of knocking. Sorry, I'm not sure why it doesn't work to click my middle mouse button so I can move over there. They also need to fix that. Just make it another... Make it, I don't know, make me have a symbol over here. I press the symbol, the cursor changes, and if I click anywhere on the map, it will move over there. Also, we're supposed to search all of the lockers because this will be, you guessed it, an ambush. I'm just too lazy to do that.
Open that locker.
Also, if you didn't realize, we have 8 slots. That's a huge amount of slots we have for the beginning of the game. Probably it will change when you get the armor.
Search that locker.
I mean the combat suit. Because they do tease you the psychic combat suit, but you cannot really use it or get it in the beginning. Even though it will be in front of us. But I kind of like the direction they're going for more immersion and more setup or more build-up to the story.
The process is automated and slightly less painful. Just use the machine and you'll be right as rain. Who knows? Maybe you'll surpass Zoe. She is the best of the 20 psychics, though.
I don't know what to say about that. The story seems a little forced over here. Maybe they're, like I said, characters from the other game. But if Kondat is... had psychers that were so strong, why don't they help the other corporation since we're all fighting for the same thing? Look at this beauty.
See? Nothing to... What the...
Move to position.
A power outage?
Code 101101 initiated.
My energy.
Commence the assault.
Very energy. Follow me. Reloading, cover me!
Lobo. Lobo infantry. Well, I guess the Lobo is kind of like a faction. I thought it was only for the brainwashed soldiers. I'll just call them brainwashed soldiers. They're not really lobotomized or anything like that. Maybe they just decided to join the bad guys for some weird reason.
Engaging.
I'm really curious about the next 2 DLCs, the Insurgents and the Mercs. Insurgents will be mostly about weapon modding and of course... probably more weapons, I hope so. And the Mercs should be based on vehicles. So we should have a much more clear picture at that point, and the campaigns will probably become a lot easier to play. Not a lot easier, but I mean a lot more interesting. By the way, there's no way to revive yourself. You don't have a revive stick and you don't have a medic.
Here? Not even Elysium knew about this facility. Quickly, you have to repel the attackers. I'll prime the self-destruct and initiate an evac order. Good luck, Marshal.
Locker here.
This sounds like that episode from The Mandalorian in AG-11. When he says, I cannot be captured, I'll initiate self-destruct. And we say, what? What self-destruct? Don't activate self-destruct. We can do this. We can save everyone and reclaim the building. Yeah, kind of a long build-up for the game. And believe me, if you play on hard, it will not be so hard, but just get smashed. You will have to play it even more slow. Even slower than this. Of course, you could select your talents a little different or upgrade your skills a little different, but sometimes I'm just lazy when it comes to lazy game design. If the developers had the. No, were lazy, I'll be lazy as well.
Search that locker.
Almost died again, yeah. If they kill you, it's game over. Remember, there's no auto, there's no save in this one, so yeah, whatever you do, don't die. Also found a lot less medkits than I usually find. I mean, I played the game this mission 2 times already, so this is definitely the lowest amount of medkits I got. Maybe we'll get more along the way.
Taking point.
Remember, if one of your companions die, you can resurrect them with this one, with the little heart. I don't know about Brandt, he's not really shooting stuff. I mean, he's not even getting close to kill them. If he sees someone near him, he'll attack, but otherwise, no.
Reloading, cover me! Search that locker. Open that locker.
So I guess it's a waste to use this set of items, even though it looks very cool. Yeah, it looks cool.
Locker here. Locker here. Open that locker.
Still nothing interesting. Okay, I'm really waiting to start the campaign and wear that combat suit already.
Nice, a psychic is here. Maybe we can turn things around. We need to get to the helipad and secure it so we can start evacuating the staff. We'll be right behind you.
You'll have to cut through the Agony research labs. Don't worry, the plants are harmless as long as you don't ingest them.
Somehow no one believes that. As long as you don't ingest them. What if we touch them or if we breathe the same air as the plants?
Follow me.
More mysterious soldiers. Looks like we're wearing Happy Meals or something that is mysterious.
Open that locker.
What's so mysterious about them? We don't know what they're called, but they definitely seem hostile.
Reloading.
Open that. Yeah, what locker. A waste of time with that shield and rod.
Single file on me.
You know what, let's just go like this. Also over here, try to go hugging the wall, because if you don't hug the wall, these enemies will respawn forever. They are infinitely respawning.
Go, go, go.
So don't try to kill all of them.
Attacking. Reloading.
That's why I got my first death. I was on hard difficulty and I was trying to survive all of this, but just end up going in front of more and more enemies.
Go.
Let's rock! Go, go, go! Search that locker.
Another thing is that you can probably get a lot more lockers and maybe you can find more useful stuff. Hold like me. Once I found the turret, but it's not really worth it. Let's just go and do the mission itself.
Move here. Terminating. Attacking. Single file on me.
Sorry, I don't have a lot of things to comment right now. I'm just trying to get past the annoying parts of the game. I like the more immersive story, I like the more custom made locations, but they should be more custom made. I mean, look at this. They seem like normal soldiers, yes? Once you click to attack them, they double their HP. Why? Can someone? No, probably not. No one can tell me that. Also, the last guy has 32,000 HP. That's how much more damage? How much more? Yeah, this will take a long time. You basically have to dance with him, because if he kills your team members, that would be annoying. If he kills his, your bots, yeah. Out of 10 gameplay. I wonder why I'm standing still is because I need more energy regeneration. Oh, he got knocked down. I guess he was bugged because we had so much firepower on him.
We'll stay here and assist anyone else. I heard some chatter over the radio
about
more survivors trapped in the vehicle bay and up front.
I think it's the scout ship that you can use to move around in the campaign, in the skirmish, that is. That's a cool looking chain gun. You know, you don't really have enough time to look at these things because you're kind of angry because of the main mission.
Search that locker. Locker here.
Now, if you're having a problem with this mission, remember that every one of these little rooms over here actually has loot in them. Do I care about them? Not so much. You should care? Yes, you should. Okay, let's go to the next area. Which involves us kind of fighting something that is a little bigger than, you know, normal soldiers. So they could have definitely handcrafted this to be a lot better, but I don't know why they chose it like this. As you can see, not even the proper difficulty modifiers work over here. They somehow get defaulted to the other one. Which I guess it's almost hard, but it's not hard. On hard, they had more HP, so I don't know if they really should have 700 something HP.
Not enough energy!
It's not very clear how this works. I guess they should add more tooltips for this. Calls in a permanent unit to assist the operator until it dies or something like that. But the good news is that we can reload the weapon a lot of times. Since we have the ammo. And also, these are police cars, and that's ambulance. It's an ambulance, so as you can see, even though it's kind of it's way ahead in the future, they're still using the same model of police cars. Two cars look like toy cars, to be honest, but they're pretty cool, nonetheless. Careful over here, Ayla. I almost died a couple of times because if 5 enemies shoot at you at the same time, you'll most likely die. It's like they're dancing in front of us, look at this. so much ammo being wasted, except for this guy. This guy doesn't do anything, so definitely don't give him the item set. I mean, he might be better in the skirmish as a bot, but in the campaign, nah. Okay, apes, do you want to live forever? They'll probably say yes. Again, there are a couple of things you can loot over here, but I'll not waste my time. We'll just go to the next objective. Another interesting thing is if you follow those soldiers, you can make the game a little safer for you, but they usually speed up in that direction, so you lose track of them. Yeah, those security forces. Oh wait, I didn't really get a good look at the ambulance. Very nice. Said, like I said, enemies continuously spawn, so you have to get moving.
Go, go, go!
Ah, it's okay, don't worry about them. We have a lot more soldiers from where they came from. It looks like we're attacking on multiple flanks. Sadly, I don't have the turret anymore, so destroying this thing will be a little harder. As you can see, they closed down the door.
Does anyone else hear that noise? Oh shit! Is that APC ramming our building?
Marshal, I'm using telepathy. We're on our way. Just hold out a little longer.
I think the Condati soldiers have almost infinite respawns. I guess our first rule of business is to kill the truck. Or to destroy it more precisely. You can also put a lot of mines over there, so you know if you know it's, I mean if you know it's coming, you can. Why don't we do that exactly? Yeah, that's a good point. Nah.
Taking point.
I guess you can kind of act like a commander unit and go in a very close situation and destroy it.
Marshal, the self-destruct is armed and the rest of us are lifting off from the helipad. More of these assailants are on the way. Hurry!
So they
remain
the death set. Also, the best time to leave is with them.
Come on, people, back on board.
But sadly, they are faster than you, so you cannot follow the soldiers. They will actually absorb a lot of the damage for you. Be very careful because this is where you have the most chances of dying. Man, I wish they would help us retreat. There are enemy units on the high ground over there as well.
Go. Move. Follow me.
I don't know how to pass this. This is a weird and annoying thing. I guess you really have to go around it, even though the soldiers went basically through it.
Single file on me. Attacking.
I guess the game really looks like a battlefield right now.
Reloading, cover me.
Follow me.
I guess Brent is useful right now because he's taking a lot of the damage for us. Yeah, so your boss will simply die and there's no way you can help them. I guess these are all our troops. And this is the Vlak. Actually, let's get a closer look at it. Oh, nice. I just want to look at the locomotive. I guess we have railroads all over the place. Come on, I like trains. Show me the locomotive. Oh, it's the other way. I never reached this point before.
On me.
Oh, that's a friendly. And you saw not spot that guy died. If I would have went to save him, I would probably have died. Or maybe not. But still probably not worth taking the chance. Nice, this looks like a real destroyer. Okay, this will be the thumbnail. Very cool. Okay, let's finish the mission because I am a bit bored of it already. You don't really play the game. This is kind of like an introduction, but it's not very well made in my opinion. Victory! Okay, we won. Sadly, you probably don't get a lot of... They should just give you bonus experience for this mission. They should give you 5,000 points at least, maybe 10,000 points.
Ah, so you must be Marshall. The name's Matt, and we'll be working together from here on in. And don't worry, I know you're a psychic. Government perks and all that.
Besides, who would even believe us? I've told like 8 people, and they all think I'm crazy. Talk about a great cover story, am I right?
And that's Helmut. He's sort of a...
That's funny.
You get used to him.
That's
Feel free
very
to
funny,
use anything
actually.
On my black. Just don't go poking holes into it.
Marshall, this was an insider attack. Our government has locked down and has scattered the other 18 psychics, so we'll be operating independently for now. I have a list of stuff we need.
That's very cool that they have the other psychics kind of like... hidden away. Oh, we took 1 point of damage to the Vlak? How? Did we accidentally hit a radiator or a chair? I guess you did poke a hole in it. Or maybe we went to the bathroom and didn't flush, so that caused 1 point of damage. Lobo Terminator autopsy. Of a morbidly disfigured marine that was sabotaging the weather control facilities. I guess you have access to the... I guess all of the campaigns are at the same time. So all of the campaigns are at the same time. So we can we're not attacked by the Robo Terminators, but we can perform an autopsy on them. Interesting. Project Forever. Project Tranquility. Ascension Dampener, okay. Okay, psychics are not real. Highly classified individuals with... Okay. That's actually a very interesting reading stuff. The disappearance of number 83. And we have Sea Lion Rifles, Riles, the Vlak Driver, or the Vlak Commander, and Helmut Turtle Killer. This one is my favorite. Grows up in a fishing village. Lucky for him, his village had all of the basics. Slacked off in school, beating his fellow classmates. To date his slightly younger but mega hot sister. The Condatis Militari was very... Come on, they mentioned that the Condatis Militari structure is very loose 1 million times in the other campaigns, in the writings of this one. some writer must really love this line, loose military structure. Take order and how to use a weapon. Okay, so I was in command of a Han over them. Nothing happened at the dam. State of the art and self-sufficient, okay. I was dating a man named Matthew Riles. Confront Matt with his fists. Left the damn fully and said, okay. Morales won the fight, not accepting defeat, okay. Matt winning the fight 263rd time. Lose this fight, I'm going to continue. Oh, okay, so I guess they mentioned that on the mission with the dam. In the first campaign. Seven days and a draw. It was really that bad? Wait, what document is not? Oh, come on. Nah, whatever. I guess this is the first mission. Many Condatus members started to call them zombies. I guess our mission is to research the Lobo Terminator autopsy. I guess we have the ship and the Vlak, the same as in the other campaigns. Well, like as always, we'll try to go for the bigger colony, so I guess we need to expand that way. There's only one over here, actually, too. Well, no, I'm not sure how you make contact with other locations. Anyway, that will be a task for another day. Sure, this will be campaign 5. See you next time, bye!